The first thing we need to do to find electron configurations is to find the number of electrons for the element. So we can find this on the periodic table, and we're going to look at the number above the element symbol, which is called the atomic number. That'll tell us the number of protons, but it also tells us the number of electrons. And we can use that number as we try to find the electron configuration for whatever element we're interested in. So we'll try an example with boron. You can see we have this chart here, and this is the general format you'll see them in. We have boron. We know we have 5 electrons. So we'll follow the chart, and we'll go down the 1s. So we write 1s, and we know that 1s holds up to 2 valence electrons. So let's put 2 electrons there. Then we have the 2s, following the arrow down there. That holds 2 electrons as well, since it's an s orbital. And we've used 4 electrons. Remember, we have 5 for boron. And we go down this row here with the 2p and the 3s. Well, we only need 1 more electron to get 5. We know that the p holds up to 6, but we only need 1. So that's our electron configuration for boron. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Notice that the numbers add up to 5, just like the number of electrons for the element. Let's try another one, chlorine. So for chlorine, we have an atomic number of 17 protons, but importantly for us, 17 electrons. So we'll go down, we have the 1s, and that holds 2. We then have the 2s, that holds 2, since it's an s orbital. And then we'll go down, 2p, which holds up to 6, and we'll put 6 in there. And if you add those numbers up, we've used 10 electrons so far. We have 17. And after the 2p in that row, we have 3s, which holds 2. We've used 12 electrons now. And then we'll go down this row here where we have the 3p, and p holds up to 6, but since we have 12, we only need 5 more to get 17. That's the electron configuration for chlorine. Let's do one more. Vanadium has 23 electrons. Again, we have the 1s, which has 2. We have the 2s, s holds 2. And then we go to the 2p with 6. We've used 10. And we have the 3s, which holds 2. And then we go down the 3p and 4s. And then we've used 20 electrons, so we need 3 more. And we have the 3d. So we'll just put those last 3 in the 3d orbital. That's the electron configuration for vanadium. Really important, though, we have 4s2, and then we go down to 3d. And that's something you should be aware of. It's supposed to do that. That's not an error. Remember that when we're doing electron configurations, we're just putting electrons around the nucleus in the pattern that we find them in nature. That's all. We can use this information to predict how atoms form chemical bonds and how they behave. So it's very useful to help us understand chemical bonding. So these are some electron configurations. The way to get really good at this is practice, try a problem, then check your answer, and then try another, and do that until you can get them right without any problems. This is Dr. B with How to Do Electron Configurations, and thanks for watching.